Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over how to get these arms moving in a nice dynamic way using hair curves. So first of all, let's get this thing lined back up on the, so its tentacles are right along the axis. So we need to go in and rotate it on the Y 22.5 degrees. And I'm just going to start off on this and we'll create a CV curve. Snapping along the grid. And by making these arms exactly 10 units, it's really easy to make sure that my control points are right at the area where there's geometry for it to deform. So that's also worth noting. And I'm gonna, the other thing is I wanna nudge that control, that curve, into the center of the arm. And so now I want to get duplicate special those, that curve. And so edit duplicate special. And we want it to be every 45 degrees, and we want 7, just like we did with the arms. I'm going to hit apply. And so now I'm going to middle mouse, drag this into the group, and we'll call this like Control curves. Great, and we want those to be nDynamic hair curves. So under the nDynamics tab, n hair, we want to make those curves dynamic. So as opposed to the other process, which is just creating hair. So we'll look down here and say make dynamic, make selected curves dynamic. So now that we've done that, we do a test play, and it looks like they're attached on the start and the end. Depending on how you created the curve, that's how it's declared. So let's find out where that parameter is. And it's really in the follicles. So if we open up the Octo control curves, now you can see we've got all these follicles. And so now if we want to look in the follicle shape, I'm shift selecting all of these. In the follicle shape, it specifies how it's attached by the point lock. So it's by default set to both ends, but really we want to just make sure it's attached at the base. So it will free up the end here. And so now we can see the curves are swinging free. But they're not deforming the arms, and that's one of the things that we want next. So so we need to figure out a way that will allow wires to deform this topology. And that's under the animation set here, under Create Deformers. And we want the wire tool. And so if we go Create Deformers, wire tool, it'll ask you to select the shape to deform and press enter. So we want to select the octopus geometry and hit enter. And now it says select the curves that you want to deform it with. So the hair system output curves is what you're looking for. So I'm going to shift select these curves and hit enter. And so now if we do a test, we should be able to see the geometry is playing and it's looking good. So I'm going to, he's looking pretty nice. So what else can we do now that we've got this all up and running? Well, we want to add some nice movement, and we also want to stop these from the geometry from interpenetrating. So that's really in the some of the parameters of the hair system, you can adjust. Let's just open this up. So we're looking in the hair system, and let's just look at like all of these attributes for the shape. And let's close some of these windows here. So the first one might be collisions that you'd look at, and so really we want these to collide with other dynamic objects, but we also want them to self-collide. And we can adjust the collision width offset just a little bit, because by default we've got this thick piece of geometry and we want to just make sure that there's some offset between the collisions. And so now that looks like I nailed it. So that's good. We can, if you want to play with this, you can sort of play with there being some static cling between the legs, and then they would stick together a little bit. You could also sort of push them apart by having a negative value. So now they'll come close to each other but push apart by using that static cling parameter. We'll just sort of set that to zero for now and really go into the dynamics properties under like turbulence. And so if we just wanted this to randomly flap its arms around, let's find the under forces so we could adjust like the mass, how heavy those are to other objects, and also like the intensity of the turbulence. So now we've got this octopus, whipping its legs around in a frenzy, right? So you don't want to overdo it, but it's starting to get there. Awesome. Looking good. So the final thing that you might animate or play with is adjusting the start curve attract parameters. And these are the start curves right here. And so after creating this all, you could bend these start curves to be look like they're wrapped around some object. If you wanted like the octopus to catch a fish or drag a boat into the ocean, you could animate this start curve attract parameter. And so right now these start curves are just sort of still splayed out. By moving these curves, you could sort of get some really, he looks like he's doing some dancing. But anyways, that's a really great start, and I think this is a good place to end the video. Thanks so much for watching.